I remember Zola Budd, for some reason, being South African, completely South African, but all of a sudden she was English, or GBR, you know, Great British, because her great-grandmother's armpit was Scottish or something.
Zola Budd's British passport application was rushed through in 6 weeks, in time for a showdown with Mary Decker in the 1984 Olympic 3,000 metres.
I can remember Mary Decker's face. This was the Olympics that she had to win. America had boycotted the previous Olympics in Moscow, so she'd obviously trained doubly hard to win here. And of course, all she had to do was defeat the barefooted one.
It was strange to me because we were running in a bunch and I'm not used to that. And Wendy Sly was coming out on my outside and they started bumping and bunching me. And the only natural thing for me to do was to go out and run at the front. And that's when the problem started, yeah.
Into the stretch, Budd and Decker make contact.
I remember being bumped or going off balance and I felt something behind me. And I tried looking back, but I couldn't see what was happening, but I knew something was happening because the crowd was booing.
Accidents happen in distance races, because there's no way that was Zola Budd's fault. You know, the fault lies in the athlete who fell over. Get out of the way.
I felt personally to blame for what had happened to Mary, and you shouldn't continue this race. And that's an immediate feeling I had after the fall. It's like your worst nightmare coming true. I just wanted to get on the plane and go back home and never see a track for the rest of my life again. I remember after the race, Mary was sitting there crying and I went up to her and I said, I'm sorry. And she just said, don't bother. And I just walked past.
It's anguish, isn't it? It's absolute anguish for Mary Decker. In a split second, all her dreams just go out the window. But boy, did she milk it.
I don't think there's any question that she was in the wrong. You have to be at least a full stride ahead before you cut in on someone.
She says she's forgiven me, but she still blames me. It's probably like people feel after a war. You forgive, but you'll never forget.